Welcome to the MindView 4 Work Breakdown Structure video. In this example, we will teach you how to use MindView to brainstorm ideas into a logical structure ideal for creating a WBS. To begin creating your work breakdown structure, left-click the MindView icon, select New, and from the view, choose Top Down. The subject or idea will be the name of your project. In this case, we will type House at Avenue Drive. Once I've created my title, I need to left-click the main branch and select Enter from my keyboard to create my first level, in this case, Foundations. To continue creating the different stages of my development or work breakdown structure, I will hit Enter once to deselect, Enter again to create my second main level, in this case, External Construction. Once I have typed my second name, again, I hit Enter two times to create my third phase level, in this case, Internal Construction. To speed up this tutorial, I have simply created my additional three levels. As you can see, there are five main stages to my work breakdown structure for House at Avenue Drive: Foundations, External Construction, Internal Construction, Roof, and Yard Access. My next step is to drill down further on these five main stages to include the different areas that need to be completed. To begin creating your next level, select the branch in question, select Insert from the keyboard, and type the first stage. By hitting Enter on my keyboard, it deselects. Enter again will create another subcategory. Enter two times, and we will create the third. I will continue these same stages for external construction. By selecting the main topic, hitting Insert, and naming my topic. To speed up this tutorial, I've went ahead and created my main levels, sub-levels, and in this case, sub-sub-levels. Now the advantage of using MindView to create a work breakdown structure is you can view the WBS in several ways. You can view the objects as a mind map. Viewing as a mind map is a great way to brainstorm your work breakdown structure or to view the same information in a more organic fashion. We have a left to right or right to left view, showing the same detailed information. We have a linear outline view as well. And you can also view the information as a timeline or as a Gantt chart, which I'll show later in the presentation. In this case, we will stay in the work breakdown structure view. If you'd like to create your WBS numbering scheme, it's simple in MindView. Simply choose the Home tab, choose Numbering Scheme, and select your desired numbering scheme. As you can see, the branches or stages have been updated with the associated numbering scheme. If you'd like to add costs to your WBS, simply select a desired stage, open the Calculation tab, and create your first variable. For foundation, we will create labor hours, and we'll create materials. Once I've created these variables, I can access them from any point in the work breakdown structure. In this case, for interior, we will say it will be 50 labor hours. We will also state that it's going to be $5,000 in materials. As you can see, the costs have been included on the desired branch. As I move down to exterior, the values will be emptied, and I can enter new values. In this case, we will say 30 hours, and material cost will be an additional $2,500. Once you have entered all of your desired variable values, you can choose to create settings and create them into currency values. In this case, materials will always be a currency value, and we'd like to round that value to the second decimal place. If I'd like to do a running total on my main stage level, I can simply choose the main stage. I can simply select the desired value, for instance, labor hours. Select the drop-down arrow, choose sub-branches, and choose to total or sum all sub-branches. In this case, it will take the values for labor hours of interior, exterior, and pool, and display that on the foundations branch. I can follow the same stages to create a sub for materials by selecting the drop-down, choosing sub-branches, and choosing sum. In this case, for the foundation stage, it will take 100 labor hours and $12,500 in materials. To speed up this tutorial, I've entered all the additional remaining labor hours and materials, calculated the running totals on the different phase levels, and rolled them up all the way to the main stage level, showing 487 labor hours and $174,000 in materials. If you'd like to display completion levels and start dates as well as resources, simply select the desired branch or stage, open the task and timeline info panel, enter the duration that you'd like, any completion levels that you'd like to display, and any resource names that would complete that task. To display that information on the branch, simply right-click the desired branch, choose Show Branch Data, and turn on your specific data points. In this case, we will turn on completion, and we will also turn on the resource. If I'd like to display that information on all branches, I can simply choose the View tab, Show Branch Data, and turn these on for all branches at the same time. To speed up this example, I've updated all available stage levels with completion levels, labor hours, and materials. As you can see, all levels are rolled up to create your 100% rule. Each phase has its specific completion level based on the subcategories or substages that are listed below. As stages and levels are updated, the main phases will update as well as the main project level. In this case, we are 30% complete with the project. As soon as a stage is updated, for instance, walls, I would choose Task and Timeline Info, update the completion level to 100. That phase will update, and accordingly, so will the remaining categories, increase to 32%. One of the benefits of using MindView to create your work breakdown structure is that with one click, you can convert it into a fully functional Gantt chart. Under the View tab, choose Gantt, and MindView will convert your work breakdown structure into your Gantt chart, with your task name listed, durations, start dates, end dates, predecessors, completion levels, priorities, and resources. You can easily create your dependencies by simply left-clicking and dragging to create your predecessor or dependency levels. If you need to show your critical path, simply select Show Critical Path from the View section. If you'd like to see further information on the task, simply select the task, choose Task Information, and view all the relative information for that task, including estimated dates, constraint types, milestones, or a further predecessor listing, where you can choose different types of predecessors, such as finish to finish, finish to start to finish, start to start, or account for any associated lag time. If you'd like a more consolidated view of your work breakdown structure, you can export the file as a Microsoft Excel document. Simply choose the MindView icon, select Export, choose Microsoft Excel, and create the Advanced Excel Export. Simply choose the look and feel of your template, select the General tab, determine the elements you'd like to include. In this case, we will include completion level and resources, and we will also include labor hours and materials. I will simply choose Export, and MindView easily converts the WBS into a completed, formatted Microsoft Excel document with our task names, total levels, resources, and any relative information that I included in my work breakdown structure. If you need to make any changes to the Excel document, feel free to update any information, save that file, and from within MindView, simply choose to import from Microsoft Excel, and MindView will update with any changes that were made in the Excel document. You need to create your WBS dictionary, or you want a more linear written format of your document, choose the Word export. Simply select the MindView icon, choose Export to, Microsoft Word, choose the Advanced Word Export, select the template or layout style that you'd like to use. Under the General tab, determine what elements you'd like included, in this case, completion and resources. Choose the export option. As you can see, MindView has now converted your WBS into a linear Word document with a fully interactive table of contents with each different section and category and the relative page number. As I control click to that stage, we see the relative information with completion levels and resources. As I scroll through the document, you can see each individual stage has its own relative category. As with the Excel export, any changes that are made in the Word document, I can choose to save that file, and I can import that file back into MindView by simply choosing the MindView icon, choosing Import, and choosing Microsoft Word. Need to export your work breakdown structure to Microsoft Project? Simply choose the MindView icon, select Export, choose Microsoft Project, and MindView converts the file into a fully functional Microsoft Project document with the task information, duration, predecessors, resources, and so on. Any changes made in the Microsoft Project file can easily be imported back into MindView by choosing the MindView icon, choosing Import, and selecting Microsoft Project.